Oh, hi. Well, I was trying to solve this equation. How do I solve this? Should I do first addition or subtraction or division? So many operations coming together in one. Hi, I am Azan and welcome to the KID company with Kabir, Isha and Dhruv. Today we will learn simplification. I see Kabir and Bunty are also solving some complex problem. Let us figure out what is happening there.
Today's homework looks quite tough. Yes, it seems like the only thing simple about simplification is the name. Simplification is actually pretty complicated.
Yeah, I really wish I understood how simplification works.
And we have just 2 days to finish this pile of homework. How are we going to do it? Time to take Dhruv's help.
Hey guys, what is with the glum faces?
We have been given some difficult homework in math.
I see. What is the topic?
Simplification.
Simplification is actually quite simple, you know.
Take a look at our homework and you will understand what I'm trying to say.
Do not worry. I'm here to help. Show me your homework. Let us start with the first question. What is the solution of 5 plus 15 divided by 5?
5 plus 15 divided by 5 is equal to 20 divided by 5 is equal to 4.
No, Kabir, that is incorrect. Let me tell you why. We have learned to carry out the 4 operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division separately. Now let us further learn to solve problems in which 2 or more operations occur in the same problem. Now, when you solved the problem 5 plus 15 divided by 5, you first found the sum of 5 and 15, which is 20, and then divided 20 by 5, which equals 4. Hence, your answer was 4. Now, let us solve the same problem in the correct way. For such problems in which there are 2 or more than 2 operations involved, we use the Bodmas rule to perform the operations in a particular order. The word Bodmas stands for brackets of division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. In this rule, we first solve the operation in the brackets and then carry out division, followed by multiplication, addition, and subtraction. Now let us solve 5 plus 15 divided by 5 using the Bodmas rule. First carry out division. When we divide 15 by 5, we get 3. Now add 5 and 3, which equals 8. Thus, we get 8 as the final answer.
Oh, this is why we kept getting different answers. Now that I know the Bodmas rule, I think I will be able to solve at least some of the problems from my homework.
I am still a little unsure about the Bodmas rule. Can we take a look at another more complicated problem?
Ah, here is a challenging problem. How would you solve 265 plus 35 minus 990 divided by 10 multiplied by 2? First, we need to perform division. 990 divided by 10 gives us 99. Followed by multiplication, 99 multiplied by 2 gives us 198. On addition, the sum of 265 and 35 is 300. And finally, subtracting the two numbers, we get 102. Why don't we try one with brackets? Here, this sum has only 2 brackets. First, solve the operation under the line bracket. Then solve the operation in the round brackets. And finally, find the difference between the two numbers, which is 373. Let me do one more problem which has operations having similar brackets. We need to solve the operations in each bracket at the same time and then solve the other operations. 4 multiplied by 3 equals 12 and 18 minus 9 equals 9. Once we solve the operations inside the brackets, we can add the two numbers and find the sum. 12 plus 9 equals 21. All right, now let us find a problem with different brackets in it.
When I saw all the different brackets, it was so confusing that all I wanted to do was put my head down, forget that I have maths homework and just go to sleep. Yes, the brackets seemed so complex that I had no clue how to go about them.
Here is the simple way of solving brackets. Four kinds of brackets. When two or more brackets are present in a problem, then the brackets should be solved in the following order. Firstly, we solve the line brackets, followed by the round brackets, then the curly brackets, and lastly, the square brackets. Hence, step one will be to first solve the operation under the line bracket, which is 12 into 7 equals 84. Step two will be to solve the operation in the round bracket, which is 84 minus 9. Which equals 75. The third step will be to solve the operation in the curly bracket. So we divide 75 by 25, which equals 3. Finally, we add 52 and 3, which equals 55.
Wow, that was really complicated. But I think I understood most of it. You just have to find the innermost bracket, solve it, and work your way out. Sort of like a maze or a video game where you cross level after level to finally finish the game.
Absolutely.
Thank you for teaching us simplification and the BODMAS rule, Dhruv. I feel a lot more confident now. I'm going to finish the homework and solve some more problems to understand simplification better. Yes. And this is the last problem. There, I have answered all the questions. And I think I've got all of them right.
Me too. 265.
I'm going home now. I will see you tomorrow in school. Yes. Bye. See you, Bunty.
So this is how to solve such problem. You just need to find out the innermost bracket. And here comes the answer. Well, it was not that difficult. I am sure. You two have understood all the rules. Let us see if Kabir and Bunty have managed to finish their homework.
Kabir, Bunty, I am quite surprised. You've got all the answers correct. I'm really impressed by the two of you.
Simplification was quite simple.
Each of you gets 5 stars on your notebook.
Thank you, sir.
Wait. Here, take this next set of problems for solving too. Hope you enjoy on these problems as well.
I hope you had a lot of fun watching this episode of KID Company and learned a lot of tricks of simplification, just like Kabir and Bunty. I will see you in the next episode of KID Company. Till then, keep learning, keep practicing by logging on to topolearning.com. Bye-bye.